This is endure sound doctrine. And the memory verse is taken from 2 Timothy 4, verse 2. And it says, for the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lust shall they heap to themselves teachers having itching ears. And the Bible reading is taken from Mark 12:18-34. I read, today there are diverse kinds of doctrine. It is not surprising because Jesus had warned that many false prophets will arise in the last days, Matthew 24:24. Apostle Paul also warned against these false ministers in 2 Corinthians 11:14-15. Erroneous doctrines on grace, tithing, same-sex marriage, and many more have become commonplace in Christendom today. Usually, these false teachings sound very logical and are backed up by a wrong interpretation of the scripture. However, Christians who have the Holy Spirit in them can discern between sound and false doctrines. May you not be deceived in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. It is easy to fall prey to these teachers if you only want to serve God in pleasure and convenience. Imagine a fornicator who wants to repent, meeting a pastor who tells him that as long as he only commits a sin once in a while, the grace of God covers him. Such a pastor would not mention the fact that in Matthew 5:28, Jesus said, but I say unto you, that whosoever looketh on a woman to lust after her, hath committed adultery with her already in his heart. If such a person is not careful, he might find out too late that all fornicators, whether regular or occasional, are going to hell. Convenience or a semblance of the truth should never be your motivation for adopting a doctrine. 1 Corinthians 14:26 says, that the purpose of doctrine is edification. They nourish your spirit man. Every godly doctrine must align with the word of God, and you should be at peace when you practice it. If not, it is not the true doctrine of Christ. While it is fine to learn from someone else's perspectives on God's word, stop depending solely on other people's interpretation. Read the Bible and ask the Holy Spirit to interpret his word to you directly. There is no revelation more impactful than the one you receive firsthand from Christ himself. 1 John 2:27. Shall we please rise up as we take the prayer point? Father, please help me know and stay in your truth. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah. Let's begin and bless the name of the Lord this morning for another day in His presence, for giving us life, for making us to see this day. Let's bless His name. Let's worship Him. Let's thank Him for His grace, for His mercy, for His love towards us as Father. Let's worship Him for who He is. The Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. He's worthy to be praised. He's the King of Kings. He's the Prince of Peace. He's the one who sits in the heaven as his throne, and the earth is his footstool. Bless the name of the Lord. Give him praise. Thank him for the gift of life. Because it's not by power, it's not by might. It's by His Spirit and by His grace. Father, we give you praise. For all you have done for us. We
sanctuary. We are not in the mortuary. Father, we exalt your name, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, and of God, that you are alive, regardless of what has happened or what has not happened, still blessing. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. God said that you tell somebody that which had gone bad, I will make good again. That which has gone bad, I will make good again. God said that you tell somebody, don't be aggravated with the provocation that is coming from them. Just be calm and deal wisely. And at the end of the day, you will look back and you'll be glad with your behavior. Don't be aggravated with their provocation. Just deal wisely with them. And you will look back very shortly and you'll be glad with your behavior, with that behavior. Thank you, Lord. Most blessed, most glorious, the nations of Israel, Almighty, be glorious, the great name, most blessed, most glorious, for you. And something went wrong, and that way is getting shut again. God said that I'm opening it wider than ever before. relationship that approaches our, that ought not to be. And he will do it within the next 2 days.
Oh,
have done for us. The one that we have received on delivery. And the one that we know that you have released in this session that will come unto manifestation. We are grateful. Please receive this token from us. We that are here and our brethren that will be given online. Father, open the heavens over our lives wider than ever before. Amen. Show us more of your mercy. Amen. Grant us more of your grace. Amen. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Today is the number one of our five-day divine renewal. The number four. And by God's grace, we'll be meeting here at 12 noon, as we have been doing since Monday. 12 to 1, we are going to be worshiping God and worrying in the Spirit, praying the Holy Ghost. Sometimes you have asked God, all your prayer point is, sometimes you just need Holy Spirit, just my own strength fail me, just take over. And when you pray in the Holy Ghost, that's what is happening. It could be praying concerning somebody in your family that you will never have an idea. It could be praying concerning a covenant that your grandparents do not even have an idea that has been activated by maybe one thing you did that they did not do in their own time and is bringing issue. So let's come or connect and pray in the Holy Ghost and God help us in Jesus' name. However, we'll be having mentorship class between 9 and 10. Anybody is always invited. Some people will always ask me, what are the people that always come for mentorship? Are they special people? I don't know anybody can come that is interested in coming to learn and also to teach us. And we'll try and hold it in our office but if we discover that more people are coming, then we'll change that location for now. Tomorrow, any favor hour is what edition? Okay, somebody is telling me the good news that I should look. Fasting, I'm not fasting. There has been an adjustment. You know, yesterday we said November 1st, that is Thanksgiving Sunday, November 1st, to 30th. You see 30 days, but it has been changed from instead of Sunday, it will start on Tuesday 3rd to December 2nd. Tuesday 3rd to December 2nd. And we said that in our fasting, because of this long fast that will be coming, after the afternoon session, you are allowed to break and go away. But if you want to do bidi bidi, you know what they call bidi bidi? That is church. Don't do 14 days. You won't die. If I see that you are working like me, I just do that around it. But that's what is happening. Yeah, one brother was going to me, he was 3 years ago. He said, Pastor, I know you are doing. I'm doing that kind of work. Let's share the grace of fellowship. The grace of God. The sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, the goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. God bless you. 12 noon, let's meet here. We are free, brother.